So Mercedes Moné backstage, and I guess when they hired this Jen Pepperman to, she's scripting all of her promos, because this sounded like a, she sounded like she was reading off cue cards. So she assumed it was Julia Hart that attacked her last week, and then said maybe it was someone who wanted her to think it was Hart. Then Moné said she would be watching the mixed tag team match and said there's a price to pay. It's a price to pay when you mess with her. What did you think about this Mercedes Moné promo? So we're, I heard she's getting $10 million a year. Is that accurate?
I don't know.
Hope not.
Well, I keep hearing that number, $10 million. Is that $10 million for the term of the contract or $10 million a year?
There's no way it could be $10 million a year, dude.
Well, so Kata's getting $4.5 million.
Right. There's no way.
I don't know. I wonder what that locker room dynamic is in that company where these people are getting bank. Getting paid extensive amounts of money. The ratings haven't done a thing. You know, I wonder what that's like for the locker room morale at that place, you know?
Well, the thing is, you spent a lot of money. We don't know how much on Okada, right? Mm-hmm. He means absolutely nothing. Mm-hmm. You've spent a lot of money on Ospreay. I won't say he means nothing, but so far you haven't gotten any return back yet.
You
haven't really gotten a return on him, which you should be getting a return immediately.
We'll talk about that.
Monet's probably been the biggest failure of all. Another bad promo. Do you not see that she's not good on the mic?
No,
she's live.
She never was more
backstage. Disco and I have been saying this about her since she was in WWE. We like her. We like her look. We like her wrestling, her swag. She's not good on the mic, and she comes off like a heel.
Well, plus, okay, so let's get to the match.
Her salary is the Observer reported that it's considerably less than the $5 million a year that's rumored, but then this other report here says it's $10 million for 3 to 5 years with an opt out after three.
Okay. All right. So $10 million over the course of the contract. So, all right. So let's go to Copeland and Willow Nightingale take on Brody King and Julia Hart. Bro, this is, they're doing the same. Okay. There's two identical angles going on, and they're not really explaining it, or they're, you know, whatever. So Willow Nightingale comes out with Chris Statlander, but they're, Stokely Hathaway is still with them. He's the heel manager, and Willow and Chris Statlander are baby faces. And there still has not been a logical explanation why they would still be hanging out with Stokely Hathaway, because you just can't get, like, they're coming across as stupid baby faces. Like, they don't know that Stokely Hathaway's a jerk, right? But basically, there's a typical, you know, a mixed tag. Hart wrapped a chain around her fist and hit Willow with it while the referee's back was turned. And then Hart put Willow in the harness, and the referee called for the bell. Once again, the referee got buried here again. But Brody King and Julia Hart go over in only 8 minutes and 45 seconds. And after the match, Mercedes Moné makes her entrance with a chair in her hand, which caused Hart to exit the ring. Then Moné looked at Willow while holding the chair. Then Copeland returned to the ring, and Moné dropped the chair. And then Moné shook hands. So what you see about this incredible drama at the end of the match?
Well, I read somewhere Hart is hurt. If she's hurt, why you have her in the match unless she's not that hurt?
All right.
I can't believe she's the champion. She doesn't have a star factor to me, but okay, I think I've said that enough.
Bad facial expressions. She doesn't have any facial expressions.
Yeah, she doesn't know how to sell. I mean, she's right. Very still green. I don't know why they put the title on her. But right. As usual, they don't let anybody get heat, and that Moné came out and ran her out.
Right.
I'm not invested in this so far.
So Julia Hart injured, seemingly injured her shoulder towards the end of a match on Rampage. It led some people to believe her upcoming matches might be in jeopardy, but according to Fightful, AEW expected Hart to be medically cleared for her upcoming bout, which she was, the tag match. So it must not be, you know, doesn't keep her out of the ring. You know what I think about Copeland?
They just send her to NXT, nothing.
There's always a little train of people that no matter who AEW signs, they go after them, they bury them. Oh, they came here to coast, or they came here and they suck, you know. The thing, like, or you remember when Booker T had a TNA run, and that was the consensus area, was like, Booker looks like he's just here to coast and collect his money, you know, and he's even said that later on down the line. But Copeland, to me, seems like a guy who's really working hard. He's really trying to help AEW and either fill it back up or leave an impact and all that. I don't see any coasting from him, you know, and a lot of people want to bury him, but I think he's doing good work.
No, he's doing fine for what they give him. He goes out there performs it, like, with fire and passion.
Yeah.
But, like,
yep.
He doesn't want his stock to go down.
Right.
Like, to put him in best seven, it's like, what am I going to do? Go through the motions and just look like if I was in a terrible segment? He's trying to make him best of it. So you got to give him more credit, right?
Yo, what's up? I just want to thank you guys for watching this clip. Don't forget to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. And join our YouTube membership for hours and hours of exclusive, unedited uncensored content, and being a member will help you get involved in our upcoming live streams. Thank you for your support. Thank you for riding with us. I know you got a lot of other podcast choices, be it wrestling or other ones. And thank you for picking us. Boom.